Yeah, it's awesome. Nothing going on from over here. And I'm gonna come here. Yeah, that's just daylight reflecting off of that.
So yeah, these things are same distance apart as my shoulders, and the points on the walls correspond to where I can reach with each hand. Whoops, I can't anymore because there's things there. So here. So these are the points, like this is the space that I can reach from this spot. At this time. And then everything is built up in between. So it's like there's something about this space between me and what I'm usually looking at, which is something on a wall in an exhibition. It's almost impossible to do this in artificial light. And even in this light, at this time of day, it's starting to be a challenge because it's the wall has this almost the same exact same shade as the thread.
So it could be the SPS response. And in fact, I started working this way a few years ago, and it's changed over time, but it's become one of the ways of drawing for me, you know? Like, you know, all your life you draw, and there's some ways of explaining yourself with it, with drawing and writing that are very easy to you. So how does that come across? I injured my hand a few years ago, and I find it's really hard to do this for very long now. It's like, oh, this one stiff. So this thing, it was attached by these threads, the whole thing, and I took it apart at one point recently, thinking I didn't want them attached, but now I know I can't get it back together. But it was this very slow building process with this elastic thread, which no longer has any elastic left. So it was starting, I started with, I guess it was like more than 10 years ago, I started working on this. And it started really small and gradually growing, so you can see how in the end how it's made. And it gradually got bigger, and it was, at one point, it was able to stand up by itself, but eventually the elastic starts to give out. The elastic actually, the rubber decays, and then it can't hold itself up anymore, and then it becomes this floppy thing. And then over time, it becomes more and more. Wanting it to be like the same height as me, so that, you know, making it's always my measuring point is my own body, so that my arm's length. What's interesting, what you can still see about this is that there's something, things are attached at the bottom, like it's being held up by all these guy lines, like Gulliver's, so like some kind of, like a bunch of little people holding some kind of monumental thing in place. And when I compare that to, like, when it's blown up like that, it's this monumental, very proud thing, continues to be like that. But it comes from something that's much humbler and kind of obsessively, crazily made. It took a really long time to make. Actually, that's a friend I can just tell her to clear that. All my friends have their own thing. That's okay. Ooh. Oh yeah, like you were saying before, just move in front of the camera. It's okay. Thank you.
And when you look at it, you can see, actually, what you see, even if you're not looking for badly touched at the trade, you still can see, you can still trace some lines that you wouldn't normally see. Like, I mean, you can see them this way, but they're way more visible somehow when you turn it around and you're no longer reading the words, but you're reading the book. And then when it's turned this way, then it takes me back to the land in some way that matches, I guess, the way that I feel about that place and the way I'm connected to it, and yet I'm not there anymore, and I'm here in Montreal. And you can see the rivers coming through there. Like there. And there. And all the things that aren't said, all the things that are missing, seem to be in that gesture.